Hello everyone, and welcome back to Metal Tiger Gaming. Today we are going to review Immortals Fenyx Rising on the PlayStation 5. I found that this game was progressively better as the game had went on. The aesthetics all matched well, and there were only a few gameplay glitches. Those gameplay glitches arrived in the event of me trying to use an ability like Ares' Wrath and then opening my wings. There were times when this would just not work and would kill my character while not navigating Tartarus. So this was a big part of the latter part of the game, which kind of sucked because that was kind of when things all started happening story-wise. And when you die 3 or 4 times due to a glitch, as simple as that, it is quite frustrating. One of the primary forces was taking Greek mythology and using that as a player experience. Some of the stories were changed for comedic effect, obviously, and it felt as if you were playing through a drama. I felt that cartoonish artwork wasn't particularly my taste, but given that it was done well to weave the story, and it was not something I had dwelt on. The drawbacks of this aesthetics were that it was hard to differentiate certain areas, such as Cold Spikes or Typhon's Ichor. I liked how they imagined the Greek gods as constellations, and were able to retain my imagination for the duration of the game. Now, I think I would love to see more as far as them doing other pantheons. Like, we've already got the Greeks, let's go see maybe some of the Romans. I'd like to see some of the Scandinavian, I think that'd be cool, or Egyptian. I mean, this is also coming from the same company, Ubisoft, which I touched base on here in a little bit, that also does Assassin's Creed. So I think that would be really cool to kind of see different pantheons in this aspect. And I think it'd be really cool to see that. I think in total the game took me 33 to 34 hours, and I was also attempting to get every chest, armor piece, ambrosia, Zeus's lightning, and potion design I could tell. I felt this type of exploration was weakly rewarded, and without something I would want to do it again another playthrough. Some of the quests within the Tartarus vaults were tedious and held no intrinsic drive. I had to quit a couple of the God's Essence tasks because I had no idea what to do or where to go. So with this main issue that I had here, was I would get into these vaults and they wouldn't really give me any type of guidance as to what I was supposed to do. So I kind of felt I was running around in circles. I wasn't really able to find out what I was supposed to do. There weren't really hints or anything of that sort, which is nice because it really gave you that immersive feeling of, well, hey, I really am Fenyx and I'm really trying to figure out where I'm going, what I'm doing, how to do this, which gives me a different perspective, I think, on the game than I would normally would have thought. Because, you know, in older games, or, you know, just even some of the new gen ones that we have now, they kind of tell you what to do. And this one, they kind of just dropped you on the map and was like, do what you want to do. Which I thought was really unique. I haven't seen any other games that are like that. I mean, even the old school games on the systems like Jack and Daxter, or, you know, Sly Cooper, at least gave you some type of direction. This game really doesn't. You know, it just tells you what the little blip is as far as what your current mission is, and that's it. Which also kind of goes into this next piece here, that's because due to the fact there's a new game plus, which I'm a huge fan of, I believe that exploring the dungeons and being able to explore the map in a freestyle way made little room for the lackluster loot you were provided. And I'll explain to that here in a little bit. The game allowed you to explore wherever you wanted and however you wanted, and leveling up was based on the resources you found. This became problematic when I saw a new game plus, because I can just take my same character that I had built back through and the game would be no more difficult than the last. This means that the game does not have a lot of replayability despite the new game plus options. So what that means is in my current playthrough that took me 33 to 34 hours, I was able to max all my stats and start buffing them. So essentially, after I max it, they allow you to spend the same resources to get you know, like a minus stamina, or try to get extra health by doing certain things, or, you know, you take less damage and stuff like that. So that, to me, just kind of defeats the purpose of actually, like, trying to roam around and trying to figure things out, because why would I try to do that a second time if I can just do it the first time and the game's not going to be any harder the second time I go? Now, the one issue I do also have with the loot was I just don't know if this is something they randomized, but a lot of the stuff that I found didn't have a helmet, or they didn't have actual body armor, which made it difficult to collect all of the pieces for everything, and some of the things I liked a lot better than the others, but they just weren't really playable as far as aesthetics-wise, which you could also change too if you wanted to. They gave that option in-game, and that's just a customization piece, which I think is kind of nice. But I think that overall, the other issue you have with leveling up in this game is that it is based on the resources you have, and the enemies do not level up with you. It depends on the area you're in. So, for example, if you decided you want to drop in-game, go right to Tartarus' vault and try to go fight Typhon, you're allowed to do that. I mean, that's just straight up what you want to do. There's not really a whole lot. There's maybe two, maybe three places you can go. the fight to go among the gods, maybe, and that's it. But I just don't think it's really worth it. The magic choices were in the same scene as the drama, meaning that they accentuated the drama pieces of it and the storyline, the story-based missions here that played out was largely allowed for making the game work. This music, in my opinion at least, was nothing to write home about and appeared to be mediocre at best. This was the same company that invests a ton of money in Assassin's Creed games, and I'm disappointed they didn't do more. I know every game has a custom track, and this one does not feel right. Now, that being said, I think that maybe I'm spoiled in the last few games I've played, like such as Ghost of Tsushima, or, I mean, even Cyberpunk had a better soundtrack for this game. Miles Morales was a fantastic soundtrack. I mean, even Godfall had a better soundtrack than this game, which is saying a lot, because that's got my lowest score I've ever given to anybody. Story-wise, and this is kind of some spoiler alerts going forward here, so if you guys didn't play the game or planning to play the game, I'd stop watching, but I think that it would have made more sense to unlock some sort of godly power that Fenyx actually has intrinsically, as he is a direct son of Zeus and Thetis, which are two gods. I think that would have added more value to the replay aspect and made the long grind worth it. I was able to maximize my stats by the third gods, and the payout was minor changes. I wish they would have just been able to let you select a god to get a power from. That is just my preference. I think the story has comedic effect and is just able to hold your attention. Overall, I think I would have been better off if they had went with a more serious tone, and that would have changed the game drastically. Now, I think that this is also what I was talking about going back to them exploring from pantheons, is that, you know, Fenyx being a god himself should have had, you know, certain abilities that he would have had intrinsically. Now, being able to unlock certain ones, maybe there was 4 or 5 abilities he had, really would have upped that replayability factor, because you can get them all, and maybe there's a second storyline. But then again, maybe I'm expecting too much from these software and gaming developers. But I think that, you know, fan service is what keeps these companies lights on, and I think they should give it, you know, but that's my opinion. I think Ubisoft wanted to do something different, and I think they found a niche for historic storytelling through video games. I think that with this line of video games, I think they have a perpetrator of history, such as Assassin's Creed, and having someone who is creating their own mythology, such as Immortals, Fenyx Rising, is brilliant. I want to see more of the games from Fenyx and expand on the credibility of gods that have more logical thinkers. I found the game enjoyable despite its drawbacks. I wish the game would have had more in terms of music selection and being able to follow through with the god aspect of gaming, which is, in this case, is quite literal. I feel like they dropped the ball on that aspect, where you could have played as a god, or even maybe you could have played as Zeus or Ares or Aphrodite, but they didn't let you do that. They tried new things in terms of leveling up, and I think it would have worked with a few caveats, given that your game doesn't scale, meaning that if you were to drop in the hardest part of the map, it's not leveled out, which I think they did on purpose to discourage people who are trying to rush through the game, which is funny, because that means you're trying to discourage speedrunners. Now, I'm not saying it's not possible, but I don't see anybody trying to speedrun this game, simply just due to the lack of resources to do so. I would give this game a 6.7 out of 10. I think that it's enjoyable, but I do think it needs a lot in order to change the game to be a little more of an 8, and I think that at max it's going to be an 8. I think for me the biggest drawbacks are aesthetic, and it's just poor music choice. And I think that, you know, going forward, I think that hopefully they decide to either make a sequel to this one, where maybe he starts exploring. I saw the DLC had something to do with that. I haven't played that DLC. I just have a hard time getting back to anyone. I've already dropped 33 hours, and I feel like it's going to be more of the same. A lot of the missions were very monotonous, and it seemed to be doing a lot of the same things when I was trying to get through a vault, and they were having me do, you know, shoot this thing 4 times with a bow and arrow, and then move this box this far, and do this and that. And I thought that they varied enough where it kept them interesting, and I thought it got way better in a late game when you actually had to use your brain to solve puzzles. A lot of them were kind of mindless, a lot of them were a little more difficult, you know. I want to see more out of it. But I think that's going to wrap up our review of Immortals Fenyx Rising. If you guys enjoyed this video and want to see more reviews, hit that like button, and don't be afraid to subscribe, guys. I mean, we're working our way up to 40, and hopefully we're going to be getting up to 50 after that. Which means that I will be seeing you guys in our next adventure, which is going to be Pathless. So I'm going to start streaming that hopefully sometime this week or beginning early next week, and we will start watching the Pathless, and we'll be playing the Pathless, and we'll be going from there. So see you guys.